Good morning. Would you please stand and sing with us our call to worship?
Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Prepare ye the way of the Lord.
Let's pray together. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now will you turn and greet one another, God's house.
Thank you.
angels are sound of angel songs and all this form of game. We could join and sing all to Christ the King. Our hearts in God divine, His love lies to rise. Our trust in God divine.
It's always important in what we're doing, and we have apportionments to pay and certainly bills to pay. We get a significant amount of our money off of your generosity as you give to us faithfully in this month. And remember, we will accept year-end donations until the 31st of the month so that you can get tax credit for those. So that is very important. Please remember Chipola Family Ministries and the needs that are there. Also, three announcements connected with this week to make, and then I'll expand a little bit from where we are. We're going to have Wednesday night, it's going to be Advent Family Dinner. And there are going to be tables set up, and people are bringing their china, and I am cooking ham. And I want you to come, and I want to run out of ham. I want to run out of space. I want us to have, and please read that whole announcement, asking for reservations in so that we can have room for everybody. But I want to run out of ham, and I want to cook a lot of ham, so I want a lot of people here. This is a big event. We do this as a part of our year, kick off our White Christmas children's home contribution season, and also it's important for us to be together before we begin to scatter a little. It's also our last Wednesday night of the meal, so this is going of the year. So it's going to come this Wednesday night. It'll be a great evening, and I want you to come, and the food will be good, and we promise you it'll be a good evening. A lot of people are going to a lot of trouble. I'm just trying to say that. I want you to make sure that you don't miss that you come and you're a part of that. I'd love to have this house of God full. I hope we make this one of the annual things that you just can't miss at all. On Tuesday, the Senior Adult Ministry will be having, at noon, we'll be having their fellowship, and it's a covered dish. Alex and Brenda Engwine, who have been, I understand have been here before, our missionaries have been in Palestine and Israel, are going to be here with us, and he's going to be speaking, and he's going to be bringing us a lot of tremendous information. There'll be a PowerPoint presentation, saying that's Aaron, there'll be a PowerPoint presentation. He'll have some things and that he'll want to share with us for that. And so I'm excited about them coming. They're coming through the conference. And making their way, a sweeping turn through it, so we get to have them on Tuesday. And so we are happy with that. Also on the calendar, next Sunday night at 5 o'clock, we'll have the longest night service. The longest night is a service designed for those who are grieving, who have lost somebody, who have had an alteration in their life, a change. Financial folks, marriages go through difficulties, people are alone for various reasons. It's a service centered around those, and those who have lost loved ones of various kinds, and we have lost certainly many of those this season. So it'll be a service especially with some quiet and some reading, and that will be important, and so we want to offer that to you and to the community, because we think that's a very important thing for us to have. Now, on the 20th, we're going to have our cantata. These folks have been working a lot of hours. They've been working a lot of hours on this cantata. And then we have children who are participating. So we have children, and we're going to have adults, and we have a cantata, and we're going to be in here, and it's going to be a great day. And so I just want you to come to that evening. It'll be a nice, nice evening. In here, and I want you to mark your calendar. They have been working a long time. Of all the things that we do in the church, the choir probably has the most volunteer hours. The choir and the praise band probably have the most volunteer hours of anybody. You need to remember that, and this is our time where they come and present this to us, and we're so glad to be a part of that, because that's very, very important. And then on Christmas Eve, we're going to have a service of 9 lessons and carols. Now, I've got some folks, some readers out there who are still looking at their calendars, so I have to get back with me on this. I've just about got the readers lined up. And we're going to have some special music, and we're going to have a lot of different things, and I hope that you'll come and be a part of that. We'll sing some of your favorite carols from 3 to a little after 4. We'll have communion there. And then at 4:30, we'll open the doors and invite the families who traditionally come to kind of go communion. We'll serve it in here. And we will serve from about 4:30 to 6 o'clock. So we want to invite you to come and be a part of that. But if I've got readers out there that have lined up for 3, if you can let me know if you can be a part of it. This is a traditional time in England for the service. The most broadcast worship service in the entire world on Christmas Eve, and we're going to live through the 9 lessons and carols. It's a great thing, and I've always wanted to do that on Christmas Eve, and so we'll have an opportunity to do that. So there are a lot of things that we're doing. We're going to, today we have communion. We'll set up 2 offering plates at sort of the ends, or somewhere in there. The ushers will take care of that. Remember, this is the season, too, of our giving. Our help with Chipotle Family Ministries, we get a lot of calls. We have utilities, and that's an important thing to help people who are in this season where a lot of things are happening, and utilities are very, very important. And so I want to make sure that you do that as we come. Be patient with us. We're doing communion in here. It's a little different, and we have to get ourselves adjusted to everything. So I just want to make sure you understand that as we go. The Nolan, Hunter Nolan family is going to come in just a minute to light our Advent candles and lead us through that part of our worship experience. At the bottom of the first page, you see your response, the congregational response, and they'll prompt us in that. And the congregation response is, prepare the way of the Lord. Let's rehearse that one time so that we're fully participating with them. Let's say that. They will say, the congregation response shall be,
prepare the way of the Lord.
Thank you. You did that so well. We appreciate that. Just a moment. We're going to bring the Nolan family in.
Good morning. Today's Advent reading comes from Malachi 3, 1 through 4. I will send my messenger who will prepare the way before me. And suddenly the Lord you are seeking will come to his temple. The messenger of the covenant, whom you desire, will come, says the Lord Almighty. But who can endure this day of his coming? Who can stand when he appears? For he will be like a refiner's fire or a launder's soap. He will sit as a refiner and a purer of silver. He will purify the Levites and refine them like gold and silver. Then the Lord will have men who will bring offerings in his righteousness, and the offerings of Judah and Jerusalem will be acceptable to the Lord, as in days gone by, as in former years.
Today we continue the Advent journey as we relight the first candle symbolic of the great coming into the world. We also light the second candle, both purple candles, as symbolic of the call to prepare. Preparation is not just about decorations and purchasing gifts for family and friends. Preparation is a matter of changing our hearts and lives. May God's light show us the way to really prepare ourselves this Advent season for the coming of the Lord.
And the congregation responds,
prepare the way of the Lord.
Let us pray. May a voice cry out into the wilderness of our lives and call us to prepare the way for the Lord. May our paths be straight, our valleys be filled, and the road ahead of us be level, and our eyes may see from far the goodness of God. And may God's grace smooth out the rough places in our lives. Amen.
Amen. Gospel lesson for today comes from the third chapter of the Gospel according to Luke, verses 1 through 3. Will you stand for the word of the Gospel? In the 15th year of the reign of Emperor Tiberius, when Pontius Pilate was governor of Judea, and Herod was ruler of Galilee, and his brother Philip ruler of the region of Iturea and Trachonitis, and Licinius ruler of Abilene during the high priesthood of Annas and Caiaphas, the word of God came to John's son Zechariah in the wilderness. He went into all the region around the Jordan, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins, as it is written in the book of the words of the prophet Isaiah. The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. Every valley shall be filled, every mountain and hill shall be made low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough ways made smooth. And all flesh shall see the salvation of God. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
You may be seated. Let us pray. Renew us, O God, in our preparation as we prepare in this season of Advent. In the name of Christ, we pray. Amen. The world was a mess. You think it's bad now. You think there's stuff in the news to be frightened of and worried about. The world was in a mess. You hear the emperor. You hear Pontius Pilate. You hear Herod, who would kill members of his family, and John the Baptist eventually in order to silence the message. Annas and Caiaphas are there, and they are not happy, going to be happy when Jesus comes. You have this powerful family and all these powerful folks in there who do not care at all about people losing their lives in order to fulfill their mission or philosophy of life. The world was a mess. And if hope was going to come, it was going to come and where? How about let's go to a small village and let's go to a priest, not a great priest, by the way, by the name of Zechariah, who argues with God and goes silent before this baby is born, and who has a son who lives out in the wilderness like a bohemian and has his own baptism, and where you'd think he'd be so full of himself, he suddenly shows us he's less about him and more about what God is doing. And from that, the Word of God comes. And the Word the world needs is to prepare. Now, I know how that makes you feel, because you got a calendar, and so you think, okay, let's whip the calendar out. Let's put that on there. We got all of our events down, and we've got all of our places we have to be. Well, for us, it's a real session about where all the places are and how we're going to get there and how we're going to do the logistics and how we're going to do the mechanics. And we got a missionary coming in, and we've got things we've got to, where we've got to be, and I've got ham to cook, and we've got things that we've got to be a part of. And so life gets rearranged, and preparations have to be made. And if it's like last week, their funerals, there was one here, and then we went to Prattville for one that just absolutely, another one that absolutely tore our hearts out. We're called to prepare, not all the outside things, not the decorations, but to prepare on the inside. And so, there needs to be a message, and a messenger has to come. Well, in the Church of England, and we all came out of, that's part of our roots to the Church of England, because we're Wesleyan, and that's where John Wesley was beloved, and where he beloved himself in the Church of England. They had a unique idea, and their idea was that they would present a video, and the video would be about prayer. And specifically, it would be about the Lord's Prayer. And so they, realizing all the difficulties and struggles of the world, realize there's a message that has to be put out there, and the message is, we need to pray. And the Lord's Prayer, as I was reading through all the research, the Lord's Prayer is prayed in every single language, in every continent, in every country of the entire world. It's the one gift that seems to spread everywhere. And you may think that this is just a region totally covered by terrorists, for there are people who come back and tell us they're praying the Lord's Prayer there. It is so prominent that it is spoken, it is prayed probably over several billion times a year, but it is also prayed every single moment of every day in the entire world. Somebody's praying the Lord's Prayer. It's the first prayer given when somebody's born. It's the prayer given at baptism. It's the prayer given when somebody dies. We used it twice this past week. We pray it when we have come to the Lord's table. We pray it sometimes in meetings. We pray it when we end on Wednesday night. It's a powerful thing. So they decided what they would do is they would create this little video, and they would take this video, and the greatest medium that you have during the season of this holy season of Advent is the movie theater, because they knew something was coming out. Did you hear that the movie Star Wars is coming out? Anybody heard that? You can't shop anywhere without realizing it. So they said, well, this is what we'll do in England. We'll rent a spot in every single theater in England, and we'll run this spot, and we'll put it in there as one of the trailers, and so they put it together. So I'm going to ask Aaron, so we can get the lights flipped down a little bit. I'm going to ask Aaron, somebody want to hit the side lights. I'm going to ask Aaron to run this video. It's not very long, but I want you to see this. This is powerful stuff.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name.
Thy kingdom come.
Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day
our daily bread.
Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those
who sin against us.
And lead us not into temptation.
There would be probably 3 or 4 or 5 million people. It's the busiest time of the year, believe it or not, movie theaters. And the 3 or 4 million people would see it. So they presented this to the association that manages all of this, all of the clips and does all the stuff that's advertising, all that annoying stuff that happens before movies you've been, that you paid for. And guess what they did? No. Absolutely not. We're worried that it would offend somebody. We're worried that it would cause somebody to be uncomfortable and that somebody might find something wrong with that. And so we're not going to run it. And so the Church of England's still fighting. Now you got to remember that in England, the Queen of England is the head of the Church of England. So let me just say that's a pretty powerful advocate that they have. And so they're still fighting that battle about whether or not it's going to be there. But let me tell you what's happened. The Church of England is not sitting back on a pout and saying, oh my gosh, it's just ruined our plan and we've not gotten the word out. That clip has been seen by 30 million people everywhere, all over the world. It's been translated into other languages. It's on YouTube, and there are young people who are watching it, and there are people who don't have necessarily any faith who've been watching it. And there are places where this message has gotten out. And so the folks in the Church of England are saying, yeah, you know, this Lord's Prayer is pretty dangerous stuff. Because you're saying our Father who runs the world, and you're saying that there's a message out there, and you're saying, talking about the kingdom of God coming, and that's more powerful than any of the things that we have. And also it's dangerous because we're talking about forgiving those who sin against us. I know we want to get angry and punch them out, but we got to forgive those. And it's also saying that the world is not perfect. We are sinners. And there's all kind of messages. I don't want to get into it because I'm going to preach about some of this when we get into the new year. But what's happening is that when God has a message, God has a way of getting that message out. And so all the preparation and the people who put it together who felt like, oh my gosh, we have made all this preparation and our message is going nowhere, have suddenly discovered it has gone all over the world, and they had no idea that we'd be played in a church in Marianna, Florida. You're going to see it again. This is why we go back to this book. This is why we go back to these stories that we've heard. I've been hearing about John the Baptist since I've been growing up. And I've been preaching about John the Baptist for a long, long time. We go back to this book and we hear this message and we light these candles because the world can be a mess. Long time before it happened in San Bernardino, California. Long time before it happened in Paris. Long time before it happened in Charleston. Long time before it happened in that 16th Street Baptist Church in Birmingham, Alabama, where those Christians bombed all those small children, those girls. The world is a mess. But the message has a way of working through that by the power of God's Spirit. So we can go buy everything we want to buy, and we can just worry about our own image, and we can change who we are and what we want to have around us, and we can decorate our houses and try to make them perfect, and we can be as OCD as we want to be. But the Word of God has a way of breaking through. The world was a mess, and so God chose the son of a poor priest named Zechariah, and his name was John the Baptist. Bring the mountains down, bring the valleys up, smooth off the rough places, prepare your hearts and your lives for the coming of the Lord. That's the message of Advent for me and for you this day. God, we need to have, and we need to hear your call. And we need to be about prayer. We light candles, oh God, not just because we want to work in progression, but we light candles because it causes and catches our eyes and reminds us that we're on an Advent journey. Not a race to the 25th of December. Bless us all, we pray, in the name of Christ. Amen. Now we're going to pray. We look at the prayer list and all the names are on there. Certainly we want to pray for Mel Thomas, and we have Nancy Caitlin still on the list. We want to pray for her family, and certainly want to pray for others. So I'm going to invite us to pray silently for just a moment, and then I'll lead us in a word of prayer. And remember how we're doing this, giving you an opportunity to call names out. When you say a name, I invite you to do that. Every time I say, Lord, in your mercy, your response is hear our prayer. So let's pray silently. Lord our God, in a world that appears to be in trouble, in a world that appears to be a mess, you send a word. And you call us to prepare the way of the Lord. For all those places, O God, where they need peace and comfort and care and blessing this day, because fear has touched people's lives, Lord, in your mercy, we pray for this church, and we pray for the work and renovation, and we pray for the choir, and we pray for those who are planning worship services, and those who are planning gatherings, and those who are planning to feed people, and those who are buying for children and for senior adults, and for those who are taking down and setting up and coming together and making food and creating events for people in the life of this church. For all of those, O God, Lord, in your mercy, Now we list before you the names of those who are dear to us in our hearts and minds.
Damn, dear.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
And Freddie White.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Kathy Williams.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Elder Nelson.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Jimmy Howell.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Catherine
Ellison Hand Trust.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Charlotte Lairmore.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Gina Poole.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Dennis Brusilero.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Catherine Mayo. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Nell Thomas. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Cheryl Nelson.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Beryl Houston.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Ned Grove.
Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
For these and all others, O God, who are dear to us in our hearts, we lift them up to you. In the holy name of Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen. I'll invite